Hey guys, Happy Green Cow here again. We're going to do a PvP video. So how to PvP kind of ties in with the video I did earlier today about how to manual. So PvP is kind of, if you want the points, you want to manual it most of the time because you can't really trust the AI and how it performs, because sometimes it'll just choose to use the wrong abilities and you don't want it to use skill 1 when you have really awesome skill 3s lined up. Stuff like that. So yeah, we want to manual PvP. We'll go through just a few battles and see how they go. So, in PvP, you have the option to skip. For example, this guy's pretty strong. He's got a whole bunch of evolved guys. They're nat 2s. All of these are nat 2s, I believe. And that is a nat 4, which is really strong. So we don't want that. But let's do it for the sake of, why not? I don't even know what team I selected, actually. That was a bit of a mistake. But that's okay. I saw my dragon in there, so. Rule 1 of PvP, just put your dragon in and you should be okay. Ouch, wow, that's... what is even on these guys? I did no damage to them. Cool, alright, let's buff my guys. And probably die. Wow, that's got a lot of... okay, we're probably not going to win this one. I don't know what to do, we're going to die. Yeah, we're just going to get wrecked. Wonder if we can take... no, okay. Nope. Yeah, we're totally going to die. So sometimes you just got to die and go to the next battle. This is one of those cases. Yeah, we're totally gonna get wrecked. There goes the diva going crazy. Okay, so what we'll try and do is focus and then go from there. You'll notice I'm attacking him even though I'm at an elemental disadvantage in some cases, because some damage is better than no damage, and he's by far the weakest guy here at the moment, so we want to get him dead. You kind of just want to focus one by one until you get it. It's a buff or it's an attack. I think he's going to die, so yeah, okay, cool. It's worth doing an attack. Okay, I guess we'll go for him next. Man, they just have so much defense and HP. His team is beast in terms of their glyphs. They glyphed really, 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 really well. But I have a dragon. So cool. We'll just take a few extra turns. Come on, you could have had so many more turns. Alright. So this awkward part is... oh man. Ha. Okay. This is the last stack my vampire's gonna get. Alright, yeah, he's probably gonna win it even though it's kind of doing okay, because that diva is so sick. And his whole team is actually just really well glyphed. My guys are not glyphed very well at all. So what we'll do is we'll just order the rest of this because we're gonna die. But it's amazing seeing the difference that glyphs make. My team are glyphed very, very, very badly. They're pretty much all greens, maybe some yellows mixed in, but that's about it. That is probably... honestly, it could have been some greens, but I'm assuming he'll be mainly yellows. Possibly some greens, maybe not purples, because he's not that good, but he would have had a lot of defense glyphs, which would have helped out there. This guy, yeah, this is totally cool. We can take this team. He's gonna get wrecked. What are we gonna actually put in? Do I want to change my team at all? No, this is actually fine. I've got 2 DPS guys, so vampire and dragon. I've got this guy as well, my dancer. He's also DPS, so I'm pretty sure he's going triple DPS. I could like Anna Healer. I could go like something else. Could potentially put him in or him, but I don't know, they kind of all play the same role. Alright, we'll go with this. And this guy that we're gonna verse is gonna get completely wrecked because he's literally got 3 stars instead of 4 stars, so his guys just probably won't be that strong. This'll be a quick wreckage. Yeah, here we go. See? That's the trick, guys. Just put in your vampire and your dragon, and you should be able to win every fight, and there won't be any issue. And that's pretty much how you play the game. Let's just take care of that, and when they have one creature left, as long as it's not like a fire diva or something really bad, then you just order. Actually, there's not really many things you... Even if there's one creature of anything, it doesn't really matter. Unless it's a fire colossus, in which case that's just a weird situation. Alright, and we'll do one more because that one was weak. What is that, a fire holy sister? It is. That is a fire holy sister. This is going to be a tanky team. I kind of don't want to verse that because I just versed a tanky team in the beginning. Honestly, that team would probably wreck me. This team's probably going to wreck me as well. Because he's even evolved them. I haven't even evolved any of my creatures. I just don't really bother with this account too much. But he's got a water treant, so he'll probably beat me. Okay, we'll do it anyway because I guess it'll show everyone how strong water treant is. Water treant's really good. Probably just the most versatile, one of the most versatile units in the game. Man. Yeah, if this was just any other day, I would have skipped. Man, that Fire Samurai is just flopping. Let's take down that's just the knight, isn't it? Oh, let's take down the nymph. Get rid of the heals. Oh, why? Why is he taunted? What a stupid thing. Oh, cool. He didn't use his thing on my body. Okay, cool. Yeah, get rid of the nymph. Cool. As you can see, if you just use Fire Dragon, there will be no issues. Once you take your 5th turn in a row, their team will be mostly dead. Funny enough, we'll just go for the... We'll start working down the Water Treant. But, I don't know. His Water Treant's built and it's 5-star and it's... It's really thick. It's just gonna take a while to... Ooh, purge it. What did it purge? Oh, it purged the armor. Oh, sweet. That's exactly what I wanted to purge. So, Water Trance, skill 3, gives every unit 3 buffs. One is a defense increase buff, so that's really good. Increases your defense rating by like 300 or so. Also, it gives all your units a poison mail, so if they are attacked, they poison the creature that's attacking them. For some reason, I'm not getting any poison on... Oh, this Blade Dancer got a lot of poison, but my dragon didn't get any poison, which is really weird. Attacked him a whole bunch of times, didn't get any poison. And the third thing it does is it actually provides a heal as well. So it gives heal, armor, and poison mail. It's so good. And the heal is 15% over every single turn for 3 turns, I believe. So it's a really nice heal. Alright, the rest we can just do this. And that should be good to go. Alright, we'll just assume that he dies. But it's a knight, so he'll take about 2 hours or so to kill, maybe. And why did he even get health? What was the point in getting health? That's the way, dragon. Just take the extra turns. Oh my god, so many extra turns. How is he getting... Oh, he's totally got lifesteal on his knight. They don't have natural life leech. He's got lifesteal ruins on him. That's really annoying. It's pretty good. Life Leech is really, really good for leveling up and grinding. Let's have a quick look through one more. I could probably beat this guy. What the... I mean, that's a really good... He made that 5-star! Wait, that's just the... That's just like the... Isn't that a 2-star? What? That's... I swear that's a 2-star. It's not a... No, it's not a deer. It's the unicorn or something? Wait a second. Why did he make that a 3-star? I mean, a 5-star. Wait, I don't have one. Let's quickly check out things. I'm pretty sure it's just a 2-star thing. Yeah, it is. It's totally... It's right there. It's Unicorn Fall. Oh, wait. Is that the one that... Oh, that guy's... Yeah, okay. That guy has a really funny skill 3. So, attacks enemies... Attacks an enemy 3 times. Inflicting great damage based on your own max HP. And each one of those 3 attacks has a 15% chance to stun for one turn. But... So recently, with the new patch, they did the whole... Attacks or skills that are based on HP or based on defense have been greatly changed. So the bonuses that you get to them in terms of damage are a lot better than what they used to be. So maybe this guy just made that unicorn because he wanted to see what it was like. But I mean... Even then, it's just such a... he's just not really that good. He's really not that good of a thing. He's got that... that deer, that fire deer, that's actually a good deer. And I think the water minotaur is actually okay. It's just that I don't know why he went for that. I wonder if he really had nothing else. If so, that's amazing. Yeah, I won't play. But I want to... Kind of want to see what it does. Anyway, that'll be it for this video. Sorry for going too long. Thanks, guys.